Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is another video in the Visuals with Nags series where I'm going to discuss about map visual and a field map. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Without further delay, let's jump into today's video. We are in Power BI and I have a simple data set where I have city-wise data for each city, what is the latitude, longitude, and in which country it belongs to. And for your information, this is only for the India country. I mean, these are the different states, different cities in the India, and what are the states corresponding to those cities, and what is the population of it. So this is very simple data set. Based on that, I'm trying to demonstrate the maps. And in your case, you can always have this as a link, like if this is considered as a dimension, this can be connected to your fact tables and you can analyze any measures in the fact table. For simplicity, for understanding, I'm using the population as a measure for this entire video. Now let's try to understand this, like a map visual. Now we have this map visual, click on this and you can drag and drop, you can do it completely, so that the map visual usually cannot be a small visuals because it will not suits you well. So just create at least half of the page you should have it. Now once you have this, let me try to explain these fields: location, legend, latitude and longitude. And we will start with location. Then I will tell you at what scenarios you will go for latitude and longitude, right? So first let us try to drop the city over here, the city here, and then what we are going to see, basically we will see the how much is the population based on different size. So we can zoom in to particular place here in India. So these are the different cities with different population. So now you can see Chennai has around more than 11 million population. So it will be more than that, right? So it depends upon what you see here. So based on the population, your bubbles will change. When you remove it, you can see the different plots. So it indicates each location you have some data here. I mean to say the data informations are plotted here, the city names are plotted, but you need to view in different perspective, right? It's not a different perspective. What is the volume of data that you will indicate as a measure? You want to view each city. So bigger the size of this bubble indicates the more the population is, okay? And this is the thing. And I want to mention when you will use latitude and longitude over here. So now you can see here in the map, you have something like some particular city, that is Sanai. It is available in Japan. So if you have mapping like this, right, when you map a city in this particular location, if a particular city is available in different locations, the Power BI or any maps will confuse it belongs to which country. For that only, if you specify latitude and longitude, right, then that will be much better. Now you can see there is no way it is pointed in any country in Japan. Now everything is mapped correctly inside India. So that is why your latitude and longitude works better. So you need to find a way to get this one. Okay, I will share this information file you may use if your data is at the city level. Now this is fine. And what about the legend? So legend is like you find different colors for it, right? So for that, for each state wise, I want to split this colors. So you can use the state over here. Now you can see everything belongs to Tamil Nadu will be in purple color, and something in Karnataka it will be blue, and something over in the Madhya Pradesh it will be an orange. So different color shades you can give. So these are the different fields you can able to utilize to view it in different perspective. So this is the core logic behind it. So once you have latitude longitude, better if you have location, then you need to be more careful. Now some of the properties you can see over here is like one of the important property I want to show here is like map styles. So now you can change this map style to aerial, that is night vision, and dark mode, right? So these are the different themes you usually you can switch between these maps. Typically, like this light visual will be most preferable. Personal, it's my personal opinion, this one. Okay, the grayscale is topmost. It looks very neat and the color wise, and you can see the values over here, right? So that is what this particular map style is. And then you can explore other options to decrease or increase these bubbles, and you can have auto zoom, future zoom buttons, right? So you can have these ones whether you need it or not. So these are the properties you can go through it, and each and everything you can go through and change the properties and check it out. So this is about basic map visual. Let us try to explore the another map, that is field map. Let me duplicate it. So I will remove this one. And the where is this field map available, you can see over here. So typically this field map is used when to show the differentiation. Some consider the COVID situation, different states, what is the severity, right? In some states the COVID affection is more, and some state it is less. So lesser the numbers, you need to show the colors slightly light colors. If more the COVID cases, you need to show the dark colors. So those kind of shots you will use to view it in the field maps. For that, now instead of showing this one at the city level, you can use the states. Okay, this is where you will use it, states, right? Now you can see here there are only in India, as I said before, so only few states have this data, that is Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and something in Telangana and Madhya Pradesh, right? Now what you can see here is like you need to show the values over here, the state wise what values you need to show, right? So for this you can do the some kind of saturation. Let us try to pull this tooltip value here so that you can see what value is appearing. Now you can slightly change this one to data colors. Default it will be like this. Now you can change the colors of this. As I said before, if the cases are population is less, you will show green, right? If the population is more, in our case it's a population, but I whatever examples I gave, it's number of active cases. Now when I say it like this, as soon as you see here, the lighter the color, the lesser the population. You see the Telangana is least population, so you have a lighter color, and whereas you have Uttar Pradesh, you have a more population, you have red in color. So there is no need of showing this population also. Even without population measure, you can able to differentiate the colors here. The Tamil Nadu are based on the color saturation. So only one field with this color property will do for this graph. So in order to view such a graphs, such a data, you can use this one. So another thing, instead of coloring, what you can do is, people used to see this one in a legends, right? The, in the same place legend, you can show it like this to differentiate different states here. So in each state, you need to have some data so that you can plot it in different values. So it will show only the graphs here. In order to show the value, we put it in a tooltip. So tooltip will give you the extra information. So this is just a filled map. Use it to give some color saturations based on the certain measures. That is the main purpose of this filled map. And in addition, you can have this tooltip to view what is the value or belongs to it. I hope this is about two basic charts or maps, that is map and filled map, and we will try to explore other maps in our upcoming videos. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.